We've been in the fourth phase actually for quite some time now. And the fourth phase is all about dissolving our continuity fear around the idea of a viewpoint, having a fixed viewpoint. There's only one totality, and the viewpoint is always the one totality. There is no other viewpoint. So we have been long associated with the desire to establish some sort of viewpoint on totality, which is impossible. We've used labels for this reason, and we're so used to words or labels, spiritual dualism, subject, object. We really have to work on dissolving this fixation, evaporating the fear actually around having only one actually complete emptiness of viewpoint, meaning there's just the one totality, and that's always the same viewpoint for the one totality. There isn't any separate viewpoint from that. So we use words to practice dissolving our fear around not having labels or a special viewpoint or a specific viewpoint. Without any words, how can you say you have a viewpoint? You know, without any description, without any memory, without any... So what we do is we use words here to go to get comfortable with no words, which is ultimate fifth stage abidance in non-dual reality. Now, this morning I was working through to an extraordinary extent this whole situation, and so we have to practice this. This is very important. And so the mood of repentance, nothing can happen without that. Understanding mood of repentance means you know you feel the purpose, you're sympathetic with the purpose, is that we're using labels to point out, to get used to not using labels, all right? So there's no argumentativeness. If the unrepentant, mood of unrepentance, there's argumentativeness, there's discussion, say, hey, wait a minute, now why are you using this label? And there's but here in this practice, we're understanding that we're just evaporating holistically, totally, in a general sense, not targeting any label in particular, but evaporating the whole fear around viewpoint, letting go of, we don't even have a viewpoint, but letting go of the desire for some label of totality, as if we have some viewpoint from which to label it. Okay, so we're going to go over this quickly here, just to keep things going. I've done this before, so we'll just, you know, we keep doing it. I am greater than I am, which is the one totality. I am, just I amness everywhere. There's only I amness. That's not a viewpoint, you see. Totality doesn't have a viewpoint. Totality is the one reality. There's no, a viewpoint means there's something else looking at something. Reality is not looking at itself from a viewpoint. I am greater than, okay? I am greater than any practice. I am greater than any practice. I am greater than any non-practice. I am greater than any prayer. I'm greater than any non-prayer. I'm greater than any contemplation. Greater than any non-contemplation. I am greater than any energy. I am greater than any non-energy. I am greater than being. I am greater than any non-being. I am greater than any universe. I am greater than any non-universe. I am greater than any knowledge. I am greater than any non-knowledge. I am greater than any wisdom. I am greater than any non-wisdom. I am greater than any thought. I am greater than any non-thought. I am greater than any image. I am greater than any non-image. I am greater than any truth. I am greater than any non-truth. I am greater than anything. I am greater than any non-anything. Greater than nothing. I am greater than what can be said. I am greater than what cannot be said. I am greater than any feeling. I am greater than any non-feeling. I am greater than any sensation. I am greater than any non-sensation. I am greater than any motion. Greater than any, I am greater than any non-motion. I am greater than any action. I am greater than any non-action. I am greater than any recitation. I am greater than any non-recitation. I am greater than any contemplation. I am greater than any non-contemplation. I am greater than any teacher. I am greater than any teaching. I am greater than any teacher. I am greater than any non-teacher. I am greater than any greatness. I am greater than any non-greatness. I am greater than any God. I am greater than any non-God. I am greater than any goddess. I am greater than any non-goddess. I am greater than any God-goddess. I am greater than any non-God-goddess. I am greater than greatness. I am greater than any non-greatness. I am greater than any place. I am greater than any non-place. I am greater than any space. I am greater than any non-space. I am greater than any mystic. I am greater than any non-mystic. I am greater than any bishop. I am greater than any non-bishop. I am greater than any person. I am greater than any non-person. I am greater than any citizen. I am greater than any non-citizen. I am greater than any human being. I am greater than any non-human being. I am greater than any form. I am greater than any non-form. I am greater than any pilgrim. I am greater than any non-pilgrim. I am greater than any yogi. I am greater than any non-yogi. I am greater than any force. I am greater than any non-force. I am greater than any delusion. I am greater than any non-delusion. I am greater than any wellness. I am greater than any non-wellness. I am greater than any hope. I am greater than any non-hope. I am greater than any triumph. I am greater than any non-triumph. I am greater than any master. I am greater than any non-master. I am greater than any guru. I am greater than any non-guru. I am greater than any world. I am greater than any non-world. I am greater than any sun. I am greater than any non-sun. I am greater than any oneness. I am greater than any non-oneness. I am greater than any miracle. I am greater than any non-miracle. I am greater than any cult. I am greater than any non-cult. I am greater than any middle. I am greater than any non-middle. I am greater than any abbot. I am greater than any non-abbot. I am greater than any Bhagavan. I am greater than any non-Bhagavan. I am greater than any Maharaj. I am greater than any Nanhan or Maharaj. I am greater than any priestess. I am greater than any non-priestess. I am greater than any Rigpa. I am greater than any non-Rigpa. I am greater than any sage. I am greater than any non-sage. I am greater than any seer. I am greater than any non-seer. I am greater than any light. I am greater than any non-light. I am greater than any darkness. I'm greater than any non-darkness. I'm greater than any reverend. I'm greater than any non-reverend. I'm greater than any Mahatma. I'm greater than any non-Mahatma. I'm greater than any progression. I'm greater than any non-progression. I'm greater than any thatness. I'm greater than any non-thatness. I am greater than any skillful means. I am greater than any non-skillful means. I am greater than any duality. I am greater than any non-duality. I am greater than any lama. I am greater than any non-lama. I am greater than any rishi. I am greater than any non-rishi. I am greater than any swami. I am greater than any non-swami. I am greater than any Mahadevi. I am greater than any non-Mahadevi. I am greater than any shaman. I am greater than any non-shaman. I am greater than any cosmic being. I am greater than any non-cosmic being. I am greater than any ascended master. I am greater than any non-ascended master. I am greater than any initiate. I am greater than any non-initiate. I am greater than any pastor. I am greater than any non-pastor. I am greater than any priest. I am greater than any non-priest. I'm greater than any Dharma master. I'm greater than any non-Dharma master. I'm greater than any saint. I am greater than any non-saint. And let me say, what I am cannot be found. I am cannot be not found. I am cannot be sought. I am can not be not sought. I am cannot be liberated into. I am cannot be not liberated into. I am cannot be added to. I am cannot be not added to. I am cannot be subtracted from. I am cannot be not subtracted from. I am cannot be divided. I am cannot be non-divided or not divided. I am cannot be inspired. I am cannot be not inspired. I am cannot be intrigued. I am cannot be non-intrigued. I am cannot be possessed. I am cannot be not possessed. I am cannot be disappointed. I am cannot be not disappointed. I am not cannot be pleased. I am cannot be not pleased. I am cannot be crystallized. I am cannot be not crystallized. I am cannot be puzzled. I am cannot be not puzzled. I am cannot be touched. I am cannot be not touched. I am cannot be arrived at. I am cannot be not arrived at. I am cannot be owned. I am cannot be not owned. I am cannot be given hope to. I am cannot be not given hope to. I am cannot be developed. I am cannot be not developed. I am cannot be grasped. I am cannot be not grasped. Okay, so this last part here throws a knuckleball, doesn't it? Because you say, whoa, wait a minute. Okay, remember, what we're doing here is pointing out the complete insufficiency of words, getting used to the total insufficiency of words. Even if it's a positive description, even if we say, I am, cannot be divided, we think, yeah, that's it. But you can't even say that. I am cannot be divided. I am cannot be not divided. And we say, whoa, wait a minute. Those are not the right words to say. Those are not the right words to say. What we're doing purposefully here is we're getting used to not having a viewpoint on I am. Not having a viewpoint on totality. Not having a label on it. Realizing that there's nothing that needs to be said whatsoever. Okay, nothing needs to be said whatsoever. So we're intentionally contradicting ourselves here. Even what seems to be very positive, descriptive terminology about I am. I am cannot be, can never be crystallized. We say, yeah, well, that's something we need to emphasize. But then we say, I am can never be non-crystallized. We say, whoa, that's not right, that's not right. So we're getting off the train this of rightness in words, you see. Rightness and wrongness in words, because reality has no need to be right. It has no need for description. It has no need for explanation. It has no need for words. It has no need for viewpoint. It has no need for teaching. None of that exists at all in reality whatsoever. And so we may get a glimpse of reality, and then we scramble for some way to describe it positively, and then it's gone. And we say, wait a minute, where are you going? I wanted to describe you in a positive way. I said, hey, I see you, you're non-crystallized. But what does non-crystallized mean? Isn't non-crystallized in reference also to crystallized? You say, yeah, reality is non-crystallized. Well, doesn't that infer that there's such a thing as crystallization? So, we really have to be willing to abide without the dualistic nature of words and the ambiguity dualistic nature of words. If we say reality cannot be protected, reality cannot be defiled, well, we must have some notion that something can be defiled. So ultimately, reality is nothing that can be said about, because what it is simply is. There's no other at all. So it doesn't need to describe itself to itself. And we're thinking that we need to have this viewpoint of something that's other than reality so we can like champion reality. Oh yeah, I can see, okay, reality's this way. So this is a technique that only the repentant can handle this technique, right? For sure. When you say reality is all one, reality cannot be not one. See, contradictory, totally contradictory. Reality cannot be realized. Reality cannot be non-realized. Reality cannot be embraced. Reality cannot be non-embraced. Reality cannot be increased. Reality cannot be non-increased. Reality cannot be pleased. Reality cannot be not pleased. Reality cannot be congealed. Reality cannot be non-congealed. So remember the purpose of this all. In this morning, seeing, getting very much close to abiding in this non-dualness and just looking at some, what the issues surrounding this, you know, the realization came that it's very important to be able to simply abide in that, which there is nothing to say about it. You cannot have a viewpoint on it. It's neither smooth nor not smooth. That every time we use a term, we have a mental image, you know, of what we're talking about. But reality is free of mental image because reality is the totality. The totality is always the totality. There's no way it can fall out of the totality. There's nowhere for the totality to go. The totality can never be increased. The idea, so to speak, of the totality just means always whatever is the totality. Of it all, of the totality. And so there's nothing to explain. And we can't verbally get this. So what we have to do is practice not getting it, feeling comfortable and not being able to get any verbalization actually. Because that's what we'll flee to. When we feel there's no viewpoint, say, wait a minute, I want to identify this from a standpoint. It's beyond words. It is beyond words. So, the wise thing to do is to practice this. And of course it's upsetting because they say, well, wait a minute, I need certainty. Reality cannot be certain. Reality cannot be uncertain. And it cannot be in between certainty and uncertainty. Reality cannot be one and it cannot be divided. And it cannot be undivided. It cannot be divided, it cannot be undivided, and it cannot be in between division and non-division. Reality cannot be seen, and reality cannot not be seen, and it cannot be either seen nor not seen, nor in between seeing and not seeing. It cannot be crystallized, it cannot be non-crystallized, and it cannot be in between crystallized and non-crystallized. So this should be like creating this burn in you, okay? We're trying to bring that about. That means the evaporation is working. Reality cannot be perfect. Reality cannot be non-perfect. Reality cannot be between perfect and non-perfect. Neither perfect nor non-perfect nor in between perfect and non-perfect. It's perfectly... perfectly, non-perfectly, perfectly, non-perfectly, perfectly, non-perfectly, perfectly, non-perfectly, perfectly, non-perfectly, perfectly. So the purpose is to bring up this consternation, this unsettledness, which is saying, wow, reality's not a word, reality's not a label. I need a label. I need perfectly non-perfect, a perfect non-perfectly perfect. The non-perfectly perfect, perfectly non-perfect, non-perfect, perfect, perfectly non-perfect, and not perfect, perfectly unperfectness. And be sure not to miss it. Miss it and not miss it. Reality can't be missed and it can't be non-missed. It's the non-missed miss that is the miss of the non-miss. That is the non-missed, non-missed miss of non-missed missness. It's the here-free here-ness of the now-free now-ness. Of the perfect, perfection-free perfection, dwelling in the non-dwelling, non-place of places. Now we're saying, well, I can't get it. It's the get-free get. And as the get, getting the get-free, get free get, and not getting the get of that, getting the get not free get. So this does bring about the burn. It was the whole point. Okay, phase four, you want the burn, you want it, not artificially, but by actually digging in like this, digging in. And it works. I'm definitely aware of progress. I'm able to examine all of this calmly and just say, wow, so it's so stupid. I'm aware great progress has taken place. So this phase four, a full stop in the burn, definitely works. It definitely works. We can't measure or understand how it works. It's the understanding, free understanding of the measurefully free measurelessness that is neither understood nor not understood. The more we talk like this, the better it is for us, actually, at phase four. Phase four to previous phases seems like gibberish. They get nowhere. Nothing's being clarified. It's the clarity-free clarity, right? That is neither clear nor not clear. Nor is it not clearly unclear or clearly clear. And so of course phase one, two, and three you'll say, well, no, we need clarity. But here we're going even beyond clarity here. We're going beyond need, actually. We're going beyond need. Reality doesn't need, is need free. And we can say it's needfully need free of all need free needfulness. So the purpose is to try to hear this, hear it, and then you feel a strain. It's like, ah, that's good. That means great progress is being made. The progress, free progress. So we're stripping the situation of labels, actually. All labels. We're both labeled and not labeled. Not labeled is a label too, you see. So it's the label-free, not labeled label that is not labeling the label-free label of label-free labelness. Feel this deep consternation, which is great. This means these exercises are working. That's what it means. And we're just full stop in the now of that, or full stopness. There's something screaming, I need a label to grab, hold on to. Is it perfect or not perfect? Just give me a label I can hold on to. You see, even the label of oneness is a label. It's a viewpoint. Reality doesn't need any labels. It's label-free. And from the standpoint of practicing, it is, again, the label of label-free, non-labeled, free labelness of all labeling, non-labeledness. So for those who are able to listen to this and get this burn, for sure, you are very far along. This is phase four practice. And if you're able to just feel this and say, yeah, this is what needs to be happening now, then you're in phase four. And it's a simple practice. It's not difficult either. They said, you see, what I saw this morning was just like, wow, it's so completely stupid. We just decided to go like on this, like a ride in an amusement park, trying to scare ourselves is all. That's all we tried to do. We've just been trying to scare ourselves. And we're still waiting for something. But nothing's happening. There's nothing scary that's ever happened. It's completely stupid what we've been engaged in. Totally stupid. It's so stupid that it's not even stupid. You see, so it's the stupid free stupidness. The stupid, stupid, free stupid, stupid free stupidness of non-stupid, stupid, non-stupid, stupid, non-stupidness. It's like that. That's what it is, you see. So I say, well, what it is, we're just using all this contradictory label. So this is what it is. This is what it is. And we keep practicing. Okay, this is what it is. And then we get used to, wow, there's no description that's understandable at all. Therefore, there doesn't need to be an understander, you see. There's not some understander of reality, of totality. There's not some viewpoint. There's not someone getting enlightened. There's only the totality. There's always only been the totality. There's never been anything else. There's never been any time. Time never started. We're trying to bring time to an end. It never started. So everybody's waiting for time to come to an end, not realizing it never started. Okay, this is the complete stupidity of the whole situation. We're waiting for time to end. It never started. This is the fundamental stupidity that we're engrossed in. As I saw the vision of oneness, I saw all beings just waiting, not doing anything, just silently just waiting. I said, what are they waiting for? They're all waiting for something. They're waiting for time to come to an end. They're waiting for this ride to come to an end, this ride of time. It never started. There has never been a ride of time. So it's just, you know, utterly stupid. Then the ride never started. They think, when's the ride going to start? Maybe they're waiting for the ride to start also. They're just waiting. It's going to start. It never starts. It never started. It never starts. It can't come to an end because it never started. So either whether we're waiting for it to end or whether we're waiting for it to start, both are completely stupid. And can we really put a label on complete stupidity like this? We're just, no, we have to somehow laugh it away. It's just, that's it. There is no start to it. So this waiting is all there is to it. There isn't anything more than this waiting. This waiting is just waiting, but still completely in the one totality. Just so it's inexpressible. It's so total. It's inexpressible. Any expression is damning it with faint praise. Any expression is damning it with faint praise. Calling it perfect is totally damning it with faint praise. So that's why we're saying we're getting off of this damning with faint praise thing. So it's the blissful, peaceful oneness. Well, phase four would say it's the non-blissful, blissful, non-one oneness of a, you know, getting used to, why I just can't say anything about it. It's always damning with faint praise, which is supporting the position of waiting. So what we're doing is we're evaporating this position of waiting, as if we're waiting for something to happen. When it's always the totality that's happening. So we have to get off this damning with faint praise. Any expression is damning with faint praise. Any expression whatsoever. The beatific, the glorious, the peaceful, you know, it's all damning with faint praise. So we say that the beautiful, non-beautiful, unblissful blissfulness of the here-free here-ness, of the now-free now-ness, and, you know, just let the expression evaporate itself. There's no expression whatsoever can possibly do anything but damn the totality with faint praise. Okay. Very great. So we have to keep working at this. And I'll tell you more about this later. Okay, that's it for this one.